This film is intended for eye surgeons for training and education purposes. Viewer discretion is strongly recommended.
Hello friends. Today I'll be sharing an unusual complication during cataract surgery. This is a 45-year-old lady with an intermittent cataract, and in this case the antechamber is very shallow. And we have used preoperatively the IV mannitol about 300 ml for this patient. So here I am doing the case. I make my first sight port. At this point I notice something unusual. At the first glance I am suspecting that the tense anticapsule has been nicked by the sight port. Well, I do not have the luxury of the replay then, but now in this replay we can see that the blade looks like it has touched the anticapsule. This has happened in spite of using an MVR blade which does not traverse much into the antechamber. Well, this suspicion still at the back of my mind, I carefully make this other side port and then I stain the capsule. Once the staining is done, the obvious is confirmed. So we can clearly see the area of the anticapsule puncture. Now, how do we go about this situation now? The concerns here are, the puncture is in the periphery, the lens is swollen, there is a high risk of it running away to the periphery when we start to enlarge the opening. The first important tip which I would like to share here is, while introducing the OVD into the eye, I ensure that the OVD is injected into the periphery of the antechamber, far away from the area of the puncture. This is to ensure that the OVD does not get into the bag and increase the intracapsular pressure. So the trick is to inject it far away from the site of puncture. Now I am creating my 2.8mm posterior limbal main incision. Luckily until now the anticapsule is still holding well. Once the chamber is stable, then I proceed with my capsulotomy. I am using the forceps to catch one of the flap at the site of the puncture. Then my aim is to perform the initial small rexus. My goal is to ensure that the flap overlaps the site of the puncture and then extend it later. So it was important for me to rotate the flap, gently go beyond the area of the puncture and ensure that it is included under the tearing flap. And once this could be managed, I knew that I was in the safe zone. So now having crossed the danger zone, I am still careful, but now I am aiming for a bigger rexus. Thankfully the plan worked well and I ended up getting a curvilinear rexus, although which is eccentric but still serves the purpose pretty well. Once we have the rexus done, the case now becomes a routine one. The nucleus is quite soft and could be chopped and separated quite easily. Each of these fragments then consumed the pupillary plane. Then the cortex is aspirated. A multi-piece hydrophobic acrylic lens is placed in the capsular bag. The OVD both in front and behind the lens is gently aspirated out. And that's it. The case is done. Thank you for watching and hope this helps.